you so much for coming out today to join us as we celebrate a witness to the resurrection and the life and faith and love of Benny Harden. There was a group that got together weekly for study and prayer for the Cursillo community. And some of you are here today and remember that there was a time when Benny was reading this book, Jesuit Guide to Almost Everything. He was very passionate about that. You know, you'd almost swear he was Jesuit. After his passing, I found myself being invited to revisit that book. I came across this quote from St. Ignatius of Loyola that Father Martin, the author, shared. I think it fits very well as we begin our service of worship. St. Ignatius said, "A rough and unshapen log has no idea that you made into a statue. Don't be considered a masterpiece. But the carver sees what can be done with it. So many do not understand that God can mold them into saints until they put themselves in the hands of that almighty artisan." Benny is in the hands of that almighty artisan. Whole, complete, God's masterpiece. God's work. Hear these words of Scripture. "Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will never die." I would invite our musicians to sing the song with me.
Redeem our love to proclaim.
Hear these words from the very familiar 23rd Psalm. They are indeed a love letter written to you, a reminder in a time of mourning and loss that we are not alone. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. Let us pray. Eternal God, we thank you for the great company of all those who have kept the faith, finished their race, and who now rest from their labors. We praise you for those dear to us, whom we name in our hearts before you now in silence. Especially we thank you for Betty, whom you now received into your presence. Help us to believe what we have not seen, trust in you to lead us through our years. Bring us at last with all your saints into the joy of your home through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Sharing two selections from the Gospels with you. The first is from Matthew 25, verses 34 to 36. Then the king will say to those at his right hand, come, you that are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and he gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you welcomed me. I was naked, and you gave me clothing. I was sick, and you took care of me. I was in prison, and you visited me. And from Luke 10, it's familiar story, the Good Samaritan. But wanting to justify him, he asked Jesus, who is my neighbor? Jesus replied, a man was going down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell into the hands of robbers who stripped him, beat him, and went away, leaving him half dead. Now, by chance, a priest was going down that road. And when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. So likewise, the Levite, when he came to the place, and saw him pass by on the other side. But a Samaritan, while traveling, came near him, and when he saw him, he was moved with pity. He went to him and bandaged his wounds, having poured oil and wine on them. And he put him on his own animal, and brought him to an inn and took care of him. The next day, he took out 2 denarii, gave them to the innkeeper, and said, take care of him. When I come back, I will repay you whatever more you spend. Which of these three do you think was neighbor to the man who fell in the hand of robbers? He said, the one who showed him mercy. Jesus. Jesus said to him, "Go and do likewise." Shortly after the fall of 2009, remember meeting Vicki at the Cursillo gathering. You know, I kind of felt a little bit in his presence, and not just his physical size. That laughter, the love, that twinkle of mischief. Those are my first memories of Vicki. There are many others as well through the years. As Valerie and I sat at Waffle House talking about the service today, we decided that these two readings from Matthew would do a really good job of describing that. Maybe the first to tell you is far from being saved. Just a humble guy trying to do the best he could. But in that humbleness, Savior himself. That's why I shared the opening, in the opening words of St. Ignatius. He was that rough and unshapely lot, but he was used by the master craftsman to do craftsman's work for many years. As a firefighter following his service in the Navy. Crazy men and women who go into burning buildings when everybody else is coming out. The people who say, "Well, I've got the training, I'm going to do it." It's insane. Special Operations Rescue Community, that was a part of the Air Force. These things we do that others may live. Taken from the book of Isaiah. I've known some firefighters who are pretty larger in life, who understandably have a strong attitude and presence. You never guessed that's what they did when we first met him. He wasn't larger than life in that sense. He's an ordinary guy. That put him in good stead when he would help folks make H&R Block with their tax returns. He didn't care who you were. He could be a pauper. He could be a rich person. He was there to help the individual to get through the tax season, to help them get the best that they could. The reason I found about a lot this last week is we did our own taxes. And I'll admit there were a couple of times I don't want to call Ben and say, "Hey Ben, I got a question for you." Then you also believe in giving to others. It takes a special calling to go into a place that is often seen as a place of deep darkness, death row, or the penitentiary. Now, Benny and a group of Kairos people, cousins to Cursillo, I know, would go in to bring the love of God in a place of incredible darkness. I asked him about that, what it felt like. I mean, as a chaplain, I would go into prisons. There's nothing quite so unsettling as going through the gates and the clanging of the gates as they close. I was there to serve someone, see someone, listen to someone, be the love of God and the light of someone. And I knew that I'd be able to get out. But that wasn't death row. And I asked Ray about it. He smiled and said, it's a surprising thing once you gain a guy's trust. Well, how do you do that? It takes time. You just walk with him. Walk with him. Listen. Then he told me about a transformation that took place on death row because of Kairos, where even the guards noticed a difference as a result of the ministry of the Kairos community. And he didn't take his own horn. He was a part of that community. He was a part of that transformation. And in that setting, I know he saw Jesus over and over and over again. Just as he did when helping someone with their taxes. Just as he did when he was rushing into a burning building to save lives. I also got to work with him at the food pantry at Central Presbyterian. Back in the early days, where all the food was in one small closet with wooden shelves and low beams. I'm sure you can see where this is going. Working with Benny in that situation, he and I were constantly clonking our heads. Just look at each other and laugh. I guess we got hard heads. But the care in which he took items off the shelf, put them in the bags, and gave them to a neighbor in need was beautiful. I enjoyed working in that food pantry with Benny. Yeah, sometimes it took a little longer because when Benny's in the food cupboard, there really isn't room for anybody else. But the passion and the love that he showed each time he filled it back. It was a gift. I also remember as a part of our Cursillo weekend. Cursillo, a spiritual noodle opportunity for leaders. There was a reading that would be done in the chapel called The Mask. And it talked about the masks that we wear. Well, the reader typically would hide behind the pulpit in Beckwith Chapel, which was fairly big. First time I saw Benny crouch down behind the pulpit, trying not to be seen, folding onto himself. That was common. But the way he read that reading, he meant it. Because the reading talks about the masks that we all wear. Sometimes we have to wear masks. But if the mask becomes who we are, we're no longer the authentic individual whom God has created and whom God has called to serve. And we let down his mask. Talk about life, struggles. But it always came back to love and joy. Tony, I wish I'd been able to see you and Benny play together, sing together. Seeing the video, so many takes. The joy you guys brought to so many. Music was very important. Benny, it is best to follow Jesus. Just like all of us, we stumble and fall. We screw up. I know this all too well for my own sake. We do. We stumble, we trip, we fall down, we screw up. But then we pick ourselves up by the grace of God and dust ourselves off and keep going. We did that. And when life is challenging, all it does is put your faith to the test. The last few days of his life, he was in and out of it a lot, wasn't he? Had a beautiful moment of lucidity when Denise and I were with him. All of a sudden, he stamped out of it. His eyes lit up. Though he could hardly say the words, he motioned, he wanted us to pray. So we prayed. And this is one time when the pastor was happy to put someone to sleep. Because he felt that calm and that peace and was able to rest for a bit. He's going to be missed by so many people. Because his family was huge. Far beyond biological, a spiritual connection that included biology. Over the coming days, months, and years, we'll remember Betty. Stories and memories will pop up. Some will make you laugh. Some will make you scratch your head. Some will bring tears to your eyes. Embrace those moments. Embrace those memories. Embrace that man. Thomas Merton was a Trappist monk who has had an influence on my life. I think in the same way that the Ignatius began to influence on her on Betty's, said this about being a saint. For me, to be a saint means to be myself. Therefore, the problem of sanctity and salvation is, in fact, the problem of finding out who I am and discovering my true self. God leaves us free to be whatever we like. That's what Ben did. He lived into who he was, the child of God. My husband, father, brother, friend, companion on life's journey. May we indeed embrace those moments and smile. And tonight, I'll lift the pipe in this bed. Let us pray. O God, for our generations rise and pass away, we pray to all your servants who, having lived this life in faith, now live eternally with you. Especially we thank you for your servant Betty, whose baptism is now complete in death. We praise you for the gift of his life, for all in him that was good and kind and faithful, for the grace that you gave him that kindled in him the love of your dear name and enabled him to serve you faithfully. We thank you that for him death is past and pain is ended, and that he is now into the joy you have prepared in Jesus Christ our Lord. You only are immortal, creator, maker of all. We are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth we shall return. This you ordained when you created us, saying you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, your servant, many with all your saints, for there's neither pain nor sorrow, nor sighing, but life everlasting. In your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Betty. Acknowledge, we humbly pray, the sheep of your own fold, the lamb of your own flock, the servant of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and the glorious company of the saints in light. Now receive this blessing. May the peace of the Lord Christ go with you, wherever he may send you. Amen. guide you through the wilderness, protect you through the storm. May he bring you home rejoicing at the wonders he has shown you. May he bring you home rejoicing